Today, I'm going to show you the best laptops for architecture students in 2022. Unfortunately, in architecture, all the programs that we use require a lot more power than any old crap top can handle. We're going to want a laptop that lets us be mobile, work remotely, and hold up against the really late nights. We want it to be able to do all of that while also not breaking the bank. I spent 6 years in architecture school, and I've also spent some time in the architecture profession. So this selection is a list from my personal experience. I've also considered the requirements from countless architecture programs that you'll use on a daily basis. Today, I'm gonna show you a basic outline of the components that you're gonna wanna look for in a laptop. And I've made a comprehensive list of 6 laptops that you can use for architecture school. I've broken them down into 3 categories: budget-friendly, medium power, and high power laptops. I've put all of their links in the description below if you want to check them out. So it probably goes without saying, the more money you spend, you'll probably get a more powerful laptop. But wait, stick around until the end and I'll show you an architecture hack that could potentially save you thousands of dollars. I'm not sponsored by any of these products. I just know that shopping for a laptop is a pain, and I just want to try to help out a little bit. So let's begin by asking my little digital friend what we should be looking for in a laptop.
Thanks, Chris. Hi, everyone. My name is... There are 4 components that are very important for architecture school laptops. CPU. The CPU is the boss and brains of the operation. It stands for Central Processing Unit. It tells your laptop parts what to do and when. There are 2 main brands, AMD and Intel. GPU. The GPU is otherwise known as your graphics card. It stands for Graphics Processing Unit. This unit is vital for 3D modeling, drafting, rendering, and much more. RAM. RAM stands for Random Access Memory. This allows you to have multiple programs open at the same time, and it makes them feel very snappy and responsive. Last but not least is your hard drive. This is where your computer stores files and data. There are usually 2 options, HDD and SSD. HDD has moving parts, whereas an SSD acts more like a USB port. This means the SSD will be faster. This is, of course, an oversimplification, but I really hope you all got some great informative data from my time here on the channel. I wish you the best of luck finding your new laptop.
Well, thank you for your time. Let's go over the laptop list now. So now that we have a basic understanding of all the components of a laptop, you're still going to want things like a mouse, keyboard, and monitor. Check the video link in the description below, and also the one that pops up here on the screen somewhere. So the Acer Nitro 5 is going to be the first on our budget tier. It has a 15.6-inch screen, and it's a pretty good laptop for the price. I think it sits around $700 to $900. It has a nice graphics card and nice CPU for that price point. The second laptop on our budget tier is the Lenovo Legion 5. The price for this laptop sits around $1,000, which is the cap for this tier. The great thing about this laptop is it has an extremely long battery life, and it features the Legion TrueStrike keys. For our medium tier laptops, we have first on the list is the MSI Creator 15. It's a really well-balanced machine with a lot of different spec choices to choose from. And if you want to upgrade something like your memory, it would just cost a little bit of extra money. It has an ultra thin profile and an NVIDIA graphics card. It has very high-end heat dissipation and cooling capabilities, so your laptop won't sound like a jet plane blasting off every time you start it up. So this laptop is definitely strong enough to get you through architecture school with no problem. The second laptop on our medium power tier is going to be the Dell XPS 15. This is probably the most popular laptop for architecture students. It actually vents through the hinge rather than straight down towards your lap. It also has 16 million vivid colors. That is around 40 times brighter than previous models. The screen of this laptop is actually made from Gorilla Glass, so it's gonna be really durable. And on top of that, it has a very sleek design. All right, time for our high power tier. This is when things get really interesting. You're gonna spend more money, but you're gonna get more bang for your buck. And these laptops are gonna last many, many years. They're going to stay with you after you graduate and probably well into your career. The first one I want to talk about is quite a mouthful. It's the HP ZBook Studio G8. It's somewhat hard to come across, but it's definitely worth the search. It's really lightweight, weighing in about 4 pounds, so you won't feel really weighed down when you're lugging it around to all your classes. With an extremely powerful GPU and CPU, you'll be able to take on anything that architecture school throws at you. And last but not least is my absolute favorite, the Razer Blade 15 Studio. This laptop is top notch. So I actually first noticed this laptop when I was walking around studio one day. One of my classmates had it. And at first I thought it was a MacBook. And I was like, that's interesting, must be a new model or something. I asked him about it and he told me a couple great things. It has a CNC'd aluminum shell, high-end customer service, a really nice compact thin design. It's extremely lightweight. It doesn't come with all those annoying programs that Windows installs on your computer when you first boot it up. And I think one of the coolest things about this laptop is it actually has vapor-cooled internal hardware. I feel like if you brought this laptop to school, they might just give you your degree for free. So if I could go back in time to when I first started architecture school, I probably would snag this little guy. I would only suggest getting this computer if you find yourself spending a lot of time working in studio or at home. I really enjoy going to like coffee shops and breweries to work, but I just found that I spend 10 times the amount of time at studio or at home. This mini computer is actually really small, lightweight, and cost much, much less than a powerful laptop. You could have one monitor that stays in studio and then your other monitor stays at home, because of course it's kind of hard to carry around a monitor to and from classes. And then just grab yourself a small keyboard and a mouse, both of which you might purchase anyways if you got a laptop. Thanks for watching, y'all. I have all the links for the laptops in the description below so you can check them out. If you like the video, please like the video and consider subscribing if you want to see future content. Let me know in the comments below what laptop you would choose. Thank you all for your support and for hanging out with me today. I'll catch you on the next one.
Whoa.